I'm not going to be out here by myself. Bravo! Tell us what you're singing.
Kennst du das Land?
First, okay. Oops, sorry. Forgot a pencil. Need a pencil. May I have a pencil? Thanks so much. Good afternoon, everyone. Very welcome to this masterclass. And we're off.
Kennst du
very beautiful and very well, you know, thought through and performed. So congratulations to that. I would suggest the tempo a little faster in the beginning, so otherwise it's so stretched that I cannot really make sense of the phrase and the texts. And also it's vital that it sings right from the beginning, so don't start too soft. It's a big song, and so it's rarely the case, I think, that when the pianist starts a piece that it should be super, super soft. Only in if that's really is what you want to convey, that something is as soft as that. But here you have the singing needs to start in the piano straight away. So kennst du das Land, wo die Zitronen, a little faster. And you have a beautiful top and an easy, you know, it's big and wonderful. But when you're in the middle range, you can not too much down. Think up, think light. We'll hear you anyway. Kennst du das Land? You don't need to give a lot. And I think it would be good for the quality of your voice too, that you open up a little bit more here. Yes, and one thing in general, I think you should take more time. Can we take the volume down a little bit again? Thank you. Dahin möchte ich mit dir, oh mein Geliebte. You know, this is a very important word, and I felt you rushed through it a little bit every time. And there is a comma and everything, so dear, oh mein, dear, oh mein, lower, dear, oh mein geliebt, and then terzin, give us the D flat in this case, teen, you know, it's like a something floating away with a lot of nice air helping it, so don't feel that it's just the last note. It's seen. Let's move there. It needs to have a little bit more yearning and longing or something, passion to it. The German was very good. And so that when you repeat things, kennst du es wohl, he's put it in different ranges. So that's a start. I mean, he's. It's not repetitive in that way, but you can always emphasize words differently. So, kennst du es wohl? Kennst du es wohl? And wohl in this case can mean do you know it well or just do you know it at all? So it has a sort of double meaning. So it's very not strange to emphasize it differently. Yes, and when you come down to the low A sharp, das Maultier sucht im Nebel seinen Weg. Don't open it. The otherwise the vowel sounds. I'm going to hold this if you want. Take me down. Otherwise the vowel sounds are very good, but that one was you were trying to get a bit more, and then it didn't have the effect that you were hoping for. I think. Okay, let's. Go again. Where did it go? So suddenly, a piece of Schoenberg lying in front of me. Okay, so sing a routine, Tom, team, slowly and very expressively. So we need you to sort of be your own orchestra when you start. Yeah, a little bit more. Right hand. Yeah, and don't say those backbeats. Make sure the backbeats start moving on. Yes, the tom, tim, tom, and then you can slow down a little bit. Yes, thank you. Okay, so he's put in the nuance piano and the pianissimo. people are going like this, they would please like me to not be so loud and present in the hall. So, kennst du, more here, kennst du das Land? Lift it. Lift your tongue a little. Experiment with it. Kids, there's something, yes. Something changing the color a little bit that I think is not so great. So, kids, just say it. Kids.
Kids.
Yeah, you shouldn't push it either. Not, I'm not after. Kids. Kids. Very natural, natural, that's the word.
Can't.
Yeah, except not too loud. Because your voice is very present. So yes. So step away from the very present thing and just let the air through a little bit more. Don't try to point it too much. And your Barbie four. Yeah, and don't get so, you think, to remember, do not get stuck. Wo die Zitronen blühen. Even though it's slow, I want to feel you, you know, you're a bird with big wings. Don't get stuck. Kennst du das Land? Can you try, just experiment, take out the vibrato with, are you comfortable doing that?
I'll try.
Yeah? But just natural, no funny, don't compensate by pushing or anything. Yeah, one in a bar. Die gold orangen glühen. So a little bit of rubato. Mm. So it doesn't all have to be fast or anything. That's not what I'm after. But the gold orangen glühen. And gold, you have the attack, if I may use that word, is great. But then you feel you need to add volume by sort of pushing it. So just add some glitter, some sunshine. And I'll tell you something, that your second phrase, im dunklen Laub, is very lovely and natural, and your voice sounds fresh and young. So you should listen to yourself or think, what am I doing? Because you're not exactly getting the same thing in the first. I think it's not the tongue, it's a little bit more space and not so focused.
Yes, yeah.
Kennst. Yeah. So not, I don't mean super girly. Kennst, not like that. Kennst. Erbarme dich, kennst du das Land? So it's something to think about, because your voice goes in and out a little bit of sounding super lovely and sounding a little bit like you're, you know, doing that with it. So, im dunklen Laub die gold orangen grün. Im dunklen Laub. Good, nice. Very close. Dear Lord, three in a bar. Dear Lord, be a state. So when we see a dotted rhythm, we use those. Most, it gives that little bit of spritz and vitamin to songs that are like the dum tati lur bestit. You use it like a sprungbrett, where, you know, trampoline before diving into the pool. Good. Der myrtestil, and it says crescendo, but when you're going up, the volume increases anyway. So make sure your hoch is again sort of lovely and warm, and don't. You have in this hall.
I know.
You can just go, and it'll sound lovely, more or less. So one should be careful in the Wigmore Hall. Die Myrte still. Experiment in how many hundreds of ways you can use a consonant. Take it from below, lengthen it, anticipate it to early, really, you know, sit on it a little bit. But here I would, Kent, I would take it from below. Kent, du es wohl, wohl. So the first one not, and the second one to sort of show that piece of, that little bit of impatience, or how important it is to you. Yeah, you got it from underneath, just I liked how I liked it, but you put a little bit of that, yeah. So it's good, you understand exactly what I'm talking about,
yeah.
Which is why sort of we're here experimenting. It's not that you, I'm not expecting you to change everything. Okay, let's go on. I'm very excited. No, I'm just turning the page. And don't forget to stop. Möcht ich mit dir, oh mein Geliebte, dir. And do the R, I think, and not a diphthong. Don't think you have to make a lot of sound on the G flat. Kennst du das Haus? Those are not the important notes, just one level. Just feel when you're in this low register, just feel very, very tall, so you never sort of collapse on yourself or try and push down, which is my instinct, is that when I'm going low, I sort of go like this, and then much less sound comes out, and doesn't sound, for me, doesn't work. So, but if I remember and try and really stand tall, and then use these low support muscles to sort of put your voice in the low register on a nice tray or whatever. Kennst du das Haus? Auf Säulen ruht sein Dach. So it is a chest voice, but very mixed, so I'm not thinking like that. Can we just go, Is that a D flat? But, yeah, without the piano. Auf Säulen.
Auf Säulen.
Yeah, open a little bit more. Auf Säulen.
Auf Säulen.
Yeah, because you're a singer where your voice is very, sounds to me like it's very far forward, and it works for, as I've said, it works very well for you. Yeah, but down here, it, I would look for a different way of doing it. I think it's the head voice that you're closing a little bit. Mm-hmm. Auf Säulen, just let the air through as though you were speaking. Can you say, Auf Säulen, Auf Säulen,
Auf Säulen,
yeah. Yeah, so don't try and find a focus and experiment a little bit with that. Okay, well, one more time. So here I would let the excitement catch me and sing a little faster. I would do more rubato. So, es glänzt der Saal, es schi, and the schi, the e, the I in the word shimmer is the same in German and English, shimmer. You need to make it the vowel I shimmer a little bit more, not too polished and rounded and brassy. Shimmer, shimmer. Sort of like open, as though you had a big gap between your front teeth or something. Es schimmert das Gemach. Experiment with that a couple of times. Es glänzt der Saal.
Es glänzt der Saal. Es schimmert das Gemach.
I think the color was good, but it lacked a little bit of support.
Right.
So, you know, you gain some, you lose some. This is why we need to practice every day for hours and hours and hours on the same little phrase.
That's right.
But eventually, it clicks. Oh, yes, and then you can use it for everything else. Es schimmert das Gemach. You really have to make sure you get those, the low tones. Don't just sort of sweep by them. Schimmert das Gemach. Schimmert das Gemach. Es glänzt der Saal. Sounds lovely.
Es glänzt der Saal. Es schimmert das Gemach.
Yes, yes, good, good. It was good. It was better. But when the Dach and the Mach do not show that I have a big voice, or I can do a crescendo. It's not important. You said you've done the important bits by singing the words before. When you get to the long notes, we have something interesting in the piano. Ti-tum-tum. So you're just there giving your one note color to this. So that's also important for the pianist to show that it's your turn. Even though you have a diminuendo, you know, just take over. Good, I like the color, so remember that. Es glänzt der Saal one last time.
Es glänzt der Saal, es schimmert das Gemach.
Yeah, lovely, I like it. Okay, we're going to work a little bit with your in the ear. Marmorbilder sounds exquisite, but then you fall into the trap of thinking that those closed vowels like e, that you can sort of go e and it'll sound great. You know, it'll sound fine. I just go e, but no, you need the same kind of space and support. So that's something to think about. Marmorbilder stehen und sehen mich an. Mhm. Marmorbilder stehen.
Und Marmorbilder stehen und sehen mich an. Was hat man dir?
Yeah. Your A vowels for the German are a little bit like this. So again, something to think about. Marmorbilder stehen und sehen mich an. An. Again, it's the sort of palette color I'm after.
Yes.
But this is something you need to really think hard about and record yourself and,
yes,
you know, work through. So maybe you can find another color. It's sounding great, but you know.
Yeah, you to get that brightness.
Yeah. Stehen Sie mich an? And then, was hat man dir, du armes Kind, getan? The was is really important. So again, use the W in was and see what you can find with the A vowel. Was hat man dir, du armes Kind, getan? This first little seemingly meaningless word is super important. Marmorbilder stehen, one more last time. So now you changed the color on the E, but it became a little bit sort of... So just try something different. Yeah, and all the fragility you can find. Was hat man dir, what you poor child, what did they do to you? Getan. Brittle, a brittle sound, if you can. You know, something to play with. Was hat man dir? Again, we have this dotted rhythm. Oh, mein Beschütz. You are my, what's that word in English?
Beschütz. Protector.
Yeah, protector. You are my protect. Very important to get some kind of chung chung beat on it. And then, very here. Beschütz. I like long upbeats. Almost always, and after all this sort of outbursts, it's nice to collect yourself and the piano and the music with a nice long upbeat. Schützerzin, oh mein Beschützer.
Oh mein Beschützer.
Close it. Schü, just make the mouth smaller. Yes.
It's
the idea.
Roll on the
Schützert. Schützert. No, nothing. Schützert. You don't need too much volume down there, though. Schützert. Mainly sort of supported head voice. Mix of searching.
Yeah,
so stay away from that.
Yes.
Unless you're singing Verdi or something.
Yeah.
Puccini. Okay, let's go on. And now, a little bit more. Yeah, even more. Tom, tim, tom, tom. Pom, tim, tom, tom. You know, get the skates on for this one. And lots of melody for me. Yeah, again, dotted rhythm. Wolkensteg, wam papa, ti tom ti ti, tom ti ta wam papa. I love how it gives the song some energy that it needs, and every other song too. One more time. Just say it a couple of times.
Seinen Weg.
Seinen Weg.
Seinen Weg.
Yeah, the vowel is much better now. So, and it says crescendo in the piano part, but the pianist will have it in his back bones that if it's in low register, you need to wait until she's finished that phrase, and then you can do your crescendo, because we don't want that kind of power singing, I don't think. I mean, you can discuss that. Nebel seinen Weg. But somehow, I don't believe in that. But you can do it, though, because he has asked for a crescendo going up to a mezzo forte. So it's discussable. You can discuss it. Das Maultier sucht im Nebel seinen Weg. Yeah. Move it along. Das Maultier.
Das Maultier sucht im Nebel seinen Weg.
Yeah, definitely. Makes a huge difference.
Yes.
Because it gives you a way. Where is she from? Is she from Sweden? Oh, yeah, the States? Italy? Ah, English. Yeah. Seinen Weg, Weg. Yeah, it's a very English thing. Or American, actually, too. But so
oh, I'm Australian.
Oh yeah, Australia. Yeah, sorry.
Well, I don't know what's going on there. So.
But Vig, okay. In, and then in Höhlen wohnt der Drachen.
In Höhlen wohnt der Drachen, alte Brot, ihr schlüpfte Fels, und
save a little bit, because you have a great E sharp. I would just stand and do a sort of forte, maybe forte, so flute, and towards the end of the phrase, as the piano is sort of, then I would give that little extra bit of twang Wagner at the end, but yeah, not all the way through. So that's something to think about. I don't know whether you.
No, that's great.
And again, this whole verse, I would make sure that it's so excited that you cannot sing it slowly. And make sure all the 16th notes are short. In Höhlen wohnt der Drachen alte Brut. And get away from that and take a big breath. Es stürzt der Fels und über ihn die Flut. So really make your body remember that it's... Which notes are you going to, and keep those rhythms going, because it's a little bit sort of too stable. Can we go from in Höhlen?
In Höhlen wohnt der Drachen alte Brot, ist jetzt der Fels und über ihn.
I was going to say the brute needs to be quite short. brute, same in English. In Höhlen wohnt der Drachen, alte Brute. Just sing the B-R-U and then get away from it. Okay. Brute. Then we hear the meaning of the word much better. Okay, shall we skip the cans doing wollen? Dahin, dahin, or Vater. Yeah, let's do the last page from the dahin. Yes, it has a fermata on it. I'm not seeing seeing the wrong thing. It has a fermata, and you must do the fermata. Geht unser Weg, O Vater. You can give so much expression in that last, this last phrase here, and change in color and everything. But do the fermata. And so you have to remember that there is a fermata coming up a little earlier. So, and by that I mean maybe slow the tempo a little bit. You can't sort of run into it.
Yes.
Then you'll crash, so to speak. One more time. Yeah, so it doesn't become Wagner and Brunhilde, sort of that, oh, Vater, you know, the word Vater, he uses that the whole time, Wagner, which is why I'm making the connection. But I would change the color. I would go super soft or something. Oh, unser Weg, oh, Vater. Yeah.
Yes.
Or something, but not the same loud, big color.
Yes.
Some change to make it more vulnerable. Do you just want to do the fermata? Vig or whatever? Longer. Vig! Oh, Vater! You know, it's the last, we've sung it 1,000 times, and then let's go. Yeah, underline it with passion and feeling. And by when I say that, it means you have to sort of do it with your brain and the way you sing. Mm-hmm. Oh, Vater, lass uns sehen. And again, send out the teen so that it goes, it sings the whole way. Lots of little eyes floating away.
Just found that.
And when you sung Vik on this nice fermata that you did, you did it much longer this time, and you ended it in a very sort of way that I liked. It meant something. But then you can take time. Vik, let the sound sort of hover around. It's still in people's ears. Then you breathe. Then you continue. So if I were singing this, I'd probably make a huge mark in the music, you know? Yeah. So you remember that you don't, nobody's looking at their clock except me, so. Okay, last time. Hold it like you did, and try and do a diminuendo on it. And again, once you've finished, if you stop the note in a good way, people will still hear it, even though you're not singing it anymore. Lass uns ziehen.
Lass uns ziehen.
mean it. Please, now, yeah, let's go.
Yeah.
Unless you have a different idea, that you're very tired, you've sung this and you sort of relent a little bit. Yeah. Depends on how you want to do
she's
it.
She's got a need to take him. Yeah.
But something needs to be very clear on
yes.
what you're thinking.
Okay.
I'm afraid time is up. 40 minutes.
Oh, wow, great.
Goes by quickly. Bravo.
Thank you so much.
Is this yours? Yeah. Sorry, didn't get to you. Thanks. Starting with
Erwartung by Arnold Schoenberg.
Oh, sitting.
interesting song. I've never heard it, but it's beautiful. So the piano part has these quick figures that are sort of a little bit, or not just a little bit, very harp-like. And I think they should always be sort of whoosh. So not a di-do-do-do-do, not too much note by note. Even at the end, I would keep tom ti to ko 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 king kong 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 kong. So that you stay more or less with the beats. Don't give them too much time. And yeah, I think they're very important. Okay, one more time. Oh, steam. You need to think about lengthening your vowels, because that's just the way it is. Auf dem Meer, sehr langsam, auf dem Meer grünen Teiche, diphthong at the last second, neben der roten Villa. So the second time that text came, it was better because you went to the, you sang ro, you went directly to the vowel. I heard the R and then I heard ro. But the first time it was all a bit too sort of, took time for you to get to the vowel. It needs to be a little bit more distinct. Let's go from the top. Yeah, I don't think it's two phrases, I think it's one. Aus dem Meer grünen Teiche. One more time. Aus dem Meer grünen Teiche. Neben der roten. So if you wait on the bar line already in the, yeah, you can. But let's try not to do that. Aus dem Meer grünen Teiche, neben der roten Villa. And the C flat is important. What he, not the first one, it's a sort of jazzy note. It's the same note as in the first bar, but it has a different effect, so mm-hmm. I would enjoy that. One more time. So that's the end of the first section. Aus der meergrünen Teiche neben der roten Villa unter der toten Eiche, what? The moon is shining. So you need to have that in mind. That's where you're going. Scheint der Mond. Pump. The notes. Tim tom tom A flat and then T. Expected, first time, different harmony. Do, 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 da, ba. No, this time. Do, 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 pom, pom, so all that, I like it when I hear that everyone is aware that something new is coming, different harmony, and I like to underline that a little bit subtly. You know, we mustn't sort of be too exaggerate things, but it needs to be very clear anyway. Can we go do that bar? Unter der Toten. Unter der Toten Eiche. Yeah, but more time. unter der Tote, the dead oak tree, under the moon is shining. So it's a little bit, we're building up a little bit of a spooky atmosphere. And the word is Toten, 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 can you,
Toten,
yeah, Toten, no diphthong in it, there's a little bit Toten, you're wanting to, but it's a very pure vowel, Toten, Eiche,
Toten, Eiche,
yeah, much better, okay. And a little bit posture thing, yeah. So this is all good, but it's a little bit falling forward. So, so try and maybe feel that you're an inch taller than you are, so to speak. So just make sure that you're hanging from above, like a puppet. So because if you're too much like this, then it sort of loses some of the strength. Shall we go on? Etwas zögern. Tum pum. Yeah, wo ihr dunkle, again, the difference between the vowels is bigger than you think they are or than you know they are. Wo ihr dunkles abbild, and definitely separate the two B's, abbild. Wo ihr dunkles abbild. So this is slow, I think. Chum chum. Wo ihr du. So don't get stuck on the eighth notes. Remember that you're going somewhere, so to speak. Wo ihr dunkles abbild.
Wo ihr du.
Du, du, du.
Wo ihr dunkles abbild.
Ah, it's this one.
Ah, yeah, I think I'm...
Okay. The note?
Yeah, yes.
Do, ba, ba, ba. Okay, yeah. One more time.
Wo ihr dunkles Abbild durch das Wasser greift, steht ein Mann und streift einen Ring.
Ja, long. Streift ein Ring von seiner Hand. Just like let the A, enjoy the vowel A a little bit. Ring von seiner Hand. I'd like to hear that again. Chum chum. Here.
Wo ihr dunkles Abbild.
Nice.
Steht ein Mann und streift einen Ring von seiner Hand.
Good. Yeah, good, good, nice color, drei opalen. But remember the blinken is important. Drei opalen blinken. So we hear the verb. Otherwise, we maybe hear opalen, and then we don't hear what they were doing. So that's really important. Drei opalen blinken. And you can do the B and the L before the actual beat. Pale blinken. So the E is on the beat. One, drei opalen. So drei Opale blinken, durch die bleichen Steine schwimmen rot und grüne Funken. That's a short one. Funken. sparks and then und versinken. They sparkle and they do this and that and then they sink. So again, that's the end of that little section, and I like to collect, you know, gather everything together for the end of a passage, just to show that it's not just eternal movement forward. Drei opak, can you do that again? Blinken.
Drei opak, blinken.
Good.
Durch die bleichen Steine schwimmen rot und grün.
And now take some.
Und versinken.
Yeah. Und versinken. So make sure you're together. You need to lengthen the last eighth note as well. Und versinken. Instead of feeling quarter notes, you feel the eighth note when you get to that. Wham, 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 wham. So they are actually much slower. Mm-hmm. But then you pick the tempo up, und versinken, and the tempo comes back. And then when it says etwas zurückhalten, and in the space of a few seconds, we're going from some kind of soft nuance up to forte with, you know, it's quite extreme, but do it. Mm-hmm. Don't be shy. Und, can you play that bar? Und versinken to. Play the whole bar. Yeah, you need to start the crescendo already. Daddy! Where are we? No, after when your own thing. Und versinken, dum, bum. Chom, chom, chom! Yeah, so really go for it. And first here you are imitating, of course, und versinken, so again, a little bit of color on that, a little bit of accent. Und versinken from you. Und versinken.
Und versinken.
Except it says steigend, so I would let myself get more carried away. So und ver, and really even louder. Und versinken. Fum fum, loud and then. Und küsst sie. Yeah.
Pum pum.
This is where I'd like it not to be pin ta ti ta ta m ta di m ta di di tom ti ta 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 tam pa 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 pa. Yeah, so the top note is really important, and then the rest is not so important. And I think fiddle around with the pedal and see if it's better to let the pedal stay or not, or wash a little bit, so that we get the effect of the nature. The Schoenberg, that's what he's doing. He's painting a picture, and there's the diddly-did is, I don't know, water or mist or something. And so it's good that it has a bit of life on its own. Okay, the bar before Ein Fenster.
Ein Fenster
Tot sich. Mm-hmm. A window
opens.
Tot sich. Ein Fenster tot sich.
Auf.
Tot sich auf. Oh, that's a strange way of putting it. Tot. I can't read. I'm old and I need my reading glasses. Not tot. Tut, ein Fenster tut sich auf. Now I get it. Okay. So after these nature expressions, toti ba 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 ba, papi ba ba ba, chord, and you see the window. So wait a little bit. Pum 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 pum. Yeah, everything needs to be, because the harmony is not exactly 12 tone, but it's still a little difficult to follow. So make sure it's super, super in tune and clear. Ein Fenster tut, and don't feel you need to rush. There's a rest. Ein Fenster rest tut sich auf, with a ritardando on it. So. Ein Fenster, what? What's going on with a window? A window is being opened. So, you know, make it interesting, yeah. You know. He, that's what he's after. The chord directly.
Ein Fenster tut sich auf.
It's a sort of going back to tonic or whatever. It's your home note, but it's a little sharp, I think. Ein Fenster tut sich auf. One more time.
Ein Fenster tut sich auf.
Yeah, rote. It's a very. It's nothing really. It's a neutral and a little. Not quite what you were doing. Can I just hear you say that? Aus der roten Villa.
Aus der roten Villa.
Rote.
Roten.
Yes, that's good. Okay.
Aus der roten Villa.
Schwamm. So now we are getting to, what is this song about? The moon and dead oaks, and a window opening. Okay, get to the point, and this is the point. A pale hand of a woman is waving at him, so finally. I mean, it's a great build-up, but you have to use that. Winkt ihm eine bleiche Frauenhand. Take Frauenhand. So you need to take a lot of time on it. Doesn't say so, but I would definitely, because it's in a beautiful part of the voice too. Whatever it is, use it, enjoy it. Aus der roten Villa, that is diddly diddly dim, but don't wait, because it's your turn again very soon. Roten Villa, neben der toten Eiche, winkt ihm eine bleiche Frauenhand. Yeah, we dom tom ti tom tom ti tom. So I think make a sort of general fermata over that whole bar. Mm-hmm. Frauenhand. And then you're sort of playing the same thing, I know, but then you can start the tempo again and make sure it's not too slow, because here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 more bars to hear the same thing. So, you know, it's now it's your turn to be the girl waving or whatever it is. So give it some personality and not too slow. So let's go from Aus der Roten Villa one more time.
Aus der Roten Villa.
Do you run out of breath?
Yeah, a little bit, I think. It's just not managed well. I just should manage it better.
Yeah, yeah, so you need to sort of process all that. So not too much here. Winkt ihm eine bleiche Frauenhand. Let's try again from that bar, bar 24. Sorry, I forgot to ask you to do a subito piano on the Frauen. Winkt ihm eine, there's a crescendo. And yeah, sexy moment. One more time, crescendo and then Frau. Good, much better, and a nice color too. Can you just sing the eighth note of Frauen a little longer, because that's the culmination of the crescendo diminuendo. Mm-hmm. One more time. Lengthen. Winkt ihm. Ihm is a long vowel. Mm-hmm. Winkt ihm. Winkt ihm eine bleiche Frauenhand. Otherwise, beautiful color there when you did the E. One more time.
Winkt ihm eine bleiche Frauenhand.
Good, yes, that was good, except you were a little early. So, Frauenhand, so just sort of, you just need to do it a couple of times to sort it out. And you don't need to be too slow. Winkt ihm ein, this is now the quarter note. It's quite slow. And you're going, winkt ihm ein, you're using up a lot of sort of energy and air on that. Good. So I think you should work a lot on this. It'll be a great song once you... I would like to hear... Was it Le Collier?
Yes.
Do you mind going on to that?
Yeah, absolutely.
Le Collier by Du Parc aux Chaussons.
Messiaen.
Oh, Messiaen. Sorry. So to my taste in this music, I would not do portamentos at all, really.
Okay.
I would sing very purely, because there's so much sort of whew, glass harmonies going on. And to that we need very pure second violin or first, whatever you want to call yourself. So try that. Prato so sceni. And so as straight as you like to do it, with a little bit of vibrato here then. It's not forbidden to do a small coming from below, but not between, because yeah. At the when you sang it just now, there was a lot of mm-hmm. One more time. Yeah, good.
Yes.
this speaks beautifully. And I don't mean to sound like a robot. That's not what I'm after. Sort of ma ma ma. But just pure or something. I can't find a suitable word. Maybe one more time. Modere un peu vif. Chum 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 chum. Tipping it up a little bit. If you ask me, then you for an outburst like that, you need to prepare it by taking the tempo down a little bit in the piano just before. Beginning, you don't need to do accents on the last syllable. The lie just hangs on. It's the tail of the word, so you don't need to emphasize it. And the more can be a bit darker. One more time. Good, now that you showed us that something's going to happen. And indeed, it did. Sort of neutral. Good. Petit soutien vivant. It starts on an E, but he's asking for a mezzo forte, so let's try again and see what comes out. From the chord before, the soft chord. And now. Yeah, can you just try? Yes. It's good, but you're because it's quite low, you're trying to find it by doing this, which really, I can guarantee you, it does not have the effect you would or I would wish. So stand tall and try and use your support and just petit soutien, you need the air to feed the voice to get it out. Mm-hmm. So think out, think support, and don't do.
Yeah.
That's what we all want to do when it's low, but it just doesn't help. And then petit soutien, pure vowel, tiens vivant. Mm-hmm. And so try again, feel tall. and out. And even more. Yeah, good. And now you scooped a little bit, which is fine, is fine. Gra. It works very well for this word, absolutely. So you don't need to change anything there. You just need to remember to do the in the A in the gra. Just keep feeding, feeding, feeding. And you took a breath, fine, that's good. But again, get on to the A and make it spin. Grâce. And the last one is important too. Collier de renouveau.
Collier de renouveau.
Good, good. Get a different color, a new color, maybe softer. Yeah, that. I mean, not just softer in volume, but in thought as well. Dur et cocasse. Cocasse. What does that mean?
Cocasse,
shells.
So okay. It's a necklace made of.
Yeah.
Shells.
Yeah, that's right. Okay. So, yeah. But anyway, you take it. You breathe in, and then I'd like to hear just a little bit of different color.
Yeah.
But good. De sourire et de grâce. Can we go again from Collier de renouveau? Lots of these little lip muscles are going, oh.
Renouveau.
Oh. Hold it to yourself. You're going like this a little. Oh. Feel the muscles here pushing back as opposed to going out. Oh. 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 Che bellezza. Now I'm talking Italian, but you need to get this spinning here. Renouveau, and then de sourire et de grâce. One more time.
Collier de renouveau, de sourire et de grâce.
And now piano. Piano singing doesn't mean sort of inactivity. No, it's more active.
Mm-hmm.
I know you know that, but it takes remembering. Collier d'Orient. Collier d'Orient. Let your head voice sort of project right to the back of the hall. Collier.
Collier d'Orient.
Yeah. And you know what you're doing. You're going collier. You're trying desperately to hold on to the vowels, and once you've built up a way of a free and strong, sort of healthy support, which is not that kind, then you can just do all these vowels and not place them so much, because the core is fine. But then, like we had another colleague of yours before who also. You try and do these holding things with some vowels to somehow stay on your support, but it doesn't help. changes the sound to what? Collier d'Orient. Yeah, so let your mouth drop a little bit.
Yeah.
Look, yeah. Collier d'Orient.
Collier.
Yeah, yeah, much better.
All right, I'll try.
Yeah.
Collier d'Orient, collier choisi, multicolore.
It's not over till the fat lady sings. It's too getting slow too early. Wah, two, wah, dee, do, do, dee. And then you kept the tempo well, ti, to, ti, ta, ta, ti, ta, ti. Now is the rallentando. Again from the F sharp, which sounds great. So we're back to this sort of dream. Zoom, 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 zoom. Paysage. Just sneak in. Don't make a statement. Paysage, paysage. Again, with this sort of very heady voice, supported but sweet. Paysage. Sort of like you did it, but even more clear. Ah, mon collier. Ah, mon collier. One more time from the. Yeah, yeah, good, good. You're scooping and it's sort of disturbing the quality of the note. You can scoop, but it has to stay. The support is getting a bit of bad signals when you do it like that. So again, just remember to stay on your platform, even though you're scooping here and there. Open your mouth. Not the continues even though you're not singing, and gradually we understand that you're not singing anymore and we're just getting this. Beautiful. 20 minutes, I think. you're starting with Debussy.
Sibelius.
Sibelius. Norden. There we are. Just looking at the text, what's the song about to you?
To me, it's about homesickness.
Homesickness, yes. Yeah, I think so. Suddenly, in all this talk about lakes and swans and there's the word palm tree appears, which is so sort of what? Yeah. In a text by Runeberg and the song by Sibelius, you don't expect that, but it. I think so too. Yes, so good. Sometimes you need to get to the vowel a little faster, particularly these. Your support needs to be ready, your breath, the whole poise thing. One more time. Yes, so don't be too... A lot of pianists think they need to be so soft and transparent the whole time. They do. You do need to play softly and transparently a lot, but definitely not the whole time, because it's the piano parts are really interesting, and there's a lot of voices in them, and the bass and the glitter in the right hand, you know, depending on the song. But so I would go for the little bit of you know, Sibelius oomph in this here and there.
Yep.
So don't start too softly, and yeah, one more time. Chom, chom, and it's moderato. One and two and three and... Yeah. Don't feel that you have to creep in. It's not that kind of song. Yeah. I mean, it's not that kind of song either, but you know, when you sing, you sing, so... And the dissonances really pick them out. Yeah. Okay. 3, 5, 1, 1. within a fifth, and the top speaks very well for you, but the bottom doesn't. Not the bottom, but the lower. You really need them to carry out. So just take a nice breath and just start singing when it's time. One more time. And now you have to come down. The word frysa. The lakes are freezing, so you need to pick out the important words and the important consonants. Sjöarna frysa. Go with that phrase.
Sjöarna frysa.
Yes, good, yes. I see you trying, and the first bit was much better than was much, the lower note really came out much better. But when you say frysa, you have to get to the vowel quicker.
Yeah.
Frysa! Just be very efficient with your F and your R, and then get to the vowel. So the entrance note this time, I definitely that you're not quite ready. You need to be stand well, feel tall, and then just do it, throw it out, and get your air working for you, because the air is a little hesitant, it's not quite sure, is it time yet? And then it's a little behind, and the quality of the voice doesn't quite resonate.
Okay.
So the beginning of this song is something, you know, practice it over and over again. Muscles are sort of really helping me if I focus. So that bar. Yes, but don't put a vibrato on because it's sort of it's making it flop a little bit. Flip. Have to be prepared in advance, so it's flit under smaller. You have to breathe in and you just have to stand very strong, and then as you're out with it, you're playing darts, and the it's very sharp, and you go because if you're trying to do it softly and nicely, the body doesn't react. So try and go for it a little bit more. Flyttande svaner.
Flyttande svanor seglar och seglar svår snart i söder sökandes.
I admire you for that. That's good. Sjöar can be the ö can be a little bit more pointy. Sjöar, don't open it. Sjöar, sjöar. Plöjande sjöar, plöjen. An F. We need an F.
Plöjande sjöar.
We need to. Stand straight, open up. And you're searching, you're looking, and then you sort of collapse a little bit. what's the word?
No. Yeah.
It takes, you know, you need energy, so, okay, up there, okay, do it. Heavy, this song is heavy, and then we have it's, the phrase is going up, and there's a lot of words, and then we have that the G. So all that needs to be in your body and your mind, so you know exactly where you're going. I think maybe you need a little bit more time. Då ska du höga se från palmen skugga och tala. So see if you can just add a split second on the bar line, for instance, so you have time to breathe in and feel wide here, and just send it out.
Okay.
It's a real exercise, this song, but it's so so beautiful in its weird way. Can we go from då skall ett öga se er? Då skall ett öga se er från palmens skugga. Short and or proper double G. Skugga, skugga och tala. Pam, ta, di, dam. Då. Comma here, and it's in only in the song part, but I would just stop. Now that's very Sibelius. It's going like this, and then it continues. So don't feel that, can't do that, it's not proper, but it's sort of Sibelius. He's a bit weird sometimes, so can we, that was good now. Yeah, much better. So can we go directly from the top of that page? Don't get stuck. Vilken förtrollning. So don't do too much eighth notes. Vilken förtrollning vi hilar på Norden. It's three beats in a bar, so to speak. So make sure you get on the bandwagon. And your breath, the breath is not quite working for you yet on up here. It's you're holding, you're not feeding quite enough air. It's not a question of singing loud or big or pushing, but it needs air to feed through to get out there. One last time from two Nanda. Just hold back, because the voice is coming down from this high range, and you know, we don't have endless energy. We need just a little bit of help for you to come down. And then when the singing is over, then just crash and bang all you can. Don't, now you crashed on the one, which was good, but you then you did it very quick. It was like an accent more than, it's a gradual, it's a gradual, this is big and fat and good. So then, Hans, where do you want to go from? Vilken förtrollning?
Sure.
Yeah.
Vilken förtrollning,
this is such an exciting song, and it was got better and better. You just need to let it you really need to let it flow, but I think you're getting there. Shall we look at Apparition Debussy? Because that's quite a long song, and with lots of different things you can spend a fortnight on. Sorry. A conveyor belt, and very legato, and softer, and rêveusement. Debussy has written that he wants it to sound very dreamy, so don't do too much.
I was still in Sibelius.
La lune sa triste. Sort of neutral air sound, not too open. What's the note?
La lune sa triste.
It's letting a lot of not making the sound bounce against anything, any surface, with your support, but very transparent or whatever. One more time, tiro, left hand. Very good. Much lovely, lovely, lovely.
I think I was still in Sibelius land.
The only, you shortened one. La lune sa tri. And there was one note that you shortened, so you sort of broke. But much, much better. So remember that. It's a beautiful colour. And then, two, three. La lune sa triste. Two, three. De serafa. So don't rush into the next bar. Have a little bit of zen before you do the F major.
Yeah.
To look very hard. La lune s'attristait, des séraphins en pleurs, rêvant l'archéo. So it's the first little phrase of text is by itself. That's why I want you to just remember that something new is starting. Des séraphins en pleurs. And then we have the word rêvant, dreaming. Take a little bit of time. Des séraphins en pleurs, rêvant. A little bit on the bar line because of the chromatic and the meaning of the word. L'arche au bois. Take time again. Just a little, and this song can be a bit softer. Okay. We need to hear the da-da quite clearly, but the rest is just a mist with a lot of pedal on it. Yeah, ta-di, not too much on the second one.
Well,
it does say, okay. Not a bit less though. First line of the second page, the second, yeah, but the blanc sans gloire, and then you started pumping.
Yeah.
So don't do that. Sing. If you want to separate them, just sing nicely every vowel, and then there's a legato bow over sur l'azur des corolles. So, because the intonation went off, I couldn't hear what notes you were singing.
Yeah.
So be very clear. La, la, la. Well, whatever the notes are, you know, it's become so much more interesting if we actually hear the core of the notes every time. Dans le calme des fleurs vaporeuses. You did that very nicely. It says un peu retenu, and you sort of did that.
Mm-hmm.
And I've listened to this in all the recordings there are to be found on Spotify. And very few do that. Da da di da da di da to to to. But it's a typical Debussy phrase. Tu to tu to to tu to to tu. It's so full of sensuality, and if you just trot through it in tempo, ruins it for me. But you really did that very nicely. So remember to keep doing it. Can we go from dans le calme de, exactly that phrase?
Dans le calme des fleurs vaporeuses, tirées de mourantes violes, de blancs sanglots et sous-sirènes de corolles.
Yeah. Beautiful. It's the de blanc sanglot, keep your support on.
Because
you do something with it, you prepare for the next note, and then your support sort of doesn't support, basically. It just gets a little bit too slow. Ba pa pee pa pa pee pa pom pom. I agree that should come, that the tempo should come down. But then don't get slow after ti-dom, ti-dom in the piano. So sing over that. Tire de mourante viola. Take time where you need it, which is ti-tam-tam, ti. There you need a bit of time because it's a beautiful phrase. But no, tire de mourante viola. I would pick up the tempo a little bit. What? Again, from Dans le calme. Yeah, except I don't mean super energetic, I mean just not too slow. Tire de mourante viola. Underline the word mourante. Mm-hmm. Go from there to tire de mourante viola. Viola. An unexpected thing. to happen. And he hasn't written in any nuances. He doesn't say louder or softer or anything, but he does write fiévreux. So you are totally on fire, both of you, or you have a very high temperature. So can you play that much louder? You have your chord, and then you have this big broken thing. Jump, pum, pum, pum. Really feverishly. Okay, you sometimes a little slow.
Yeah.
Premier baiser was slower than the piano, for instance, so that's something you have to. You have to react to that. You have to say, why are you slowing down? And then maybe you say, because I want to, because it's important. And then you understand and you smile, your nice smile, and play slower. Or you realize, oh yeah, maybe I should not sing. So this is something, you know, you have to just work out. But keep the volume, keep your nuance up. C'était le jour béni de ton premier baiser. All that phrase should really sing in a wonderful outward way. That was good now. From the fifth floor to the first floor. Do that bar, the empty bar, the sung, not. The second to last bar, before Massongerie. Try not to diminuendo, play it out, and then you know this is full of special effects, this music. Okay, to you, Dom. So you need to do a small crescendo or a big one right at the end, and before you did it too
long. Can I go just a few bars back?
Yeah, of course you may. Debussy has written, what's this called? This and whether that.
A tenuto and a
He means détaché. S'enivre, ça va, mort, So more time, you can't do that at full speed. This is very, I love this kind of music where you could play around with it. Juicy. Ma songerie legato again. Tudum, tudum. Please.
Yeah.
Ma songerie e mort à me martyri. Ma songerie directly.
Ma songerie e mort à me
martyri. De parfum de tristesse. So when we see a word like that and that kind of interval in this music, well, then we take time. Mm-hmm. It's as easy as ABC. One, s'enivre, ça va mort. Yeah, you need to send that out a little bit. And then, so we build in these suspension moments all the time. Au prompt s'enivre, directly, s'enivre, ça va mort du parfum de tristesse. It's a roller coaster. Ti do 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 do. Que même sans regret et sans devoir laisse. One more time, sans ivresse
savamment
du parfum. Get to the S,
yeah.
Then you hold back a little bit because you're wanting to do a beautiful crescendo. Yes, I get that. But the thing is that your machine, the singing machine, is not active.
Mm-hmm.
It sort of stops and then we get this sort of dead note at the top.
Okay.
So just get it spinning. Tum ti tum tum ti. It needs this.
Okay.
By that I don't mean vibrato necessarily, but it needs to be a living, not sort of like this. Open here. It's a little. You know, to open your skull, and that sounds ridiculous, I know, but that's the feeling. It needs to vibrate all around. One more time. Can you try it when not breathe? You're breathing. I don't know whether that's a good idea. Mm. You should try when you practice it. See if that helps you stay on the support.
Okay.
If it doesn't, you know, you find out for yourself.
Okay.
Directly, que même. Keep your bowel out. Time for a little Kit Kat. And then mentally, you know, it's not a question of seconds.
Mm.
It's just, I've done that. Now I stop, I hold, and I breathe in, and I start again.
Mm-hmm.
It's just sort of focus thing. It does, so it doesn't. Should we go for, and it says animé peu à peu, I'm not sure you did that, I wasn't paying attention. And it's quand, rest. Quand, avec du du, pam, ti, do, do. Really do it. I can't hear it, it's not clear enough.
Okay.
Yeah, I can hear you're halfway into the next, and that's exactly what I don't want. Ah ha 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 pa ha ha re e. So you know the word e and means that something new is starting. Singing, what have you been singing? Quand avec du soleil aux cheveux dans la rue et dans les soirs, tu m'as paru, apparu. You appeared before me when I was out walking. And then something else. So yeah, just sing that nice and long.
Okay.
Hold, breathe in and continue. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is all very ecstatic, not too slow. It's, you're doing it really beautifully, but not, you know, we have some more coming.
Okay.
Where do you want to go from?
Con.
Tu, maybe tu mets mes en rayon. So the tempo went down because you brought it down, you took it down at some point, but then you need to, it's not over yet, so make sure you. Et j'ai cru voir la fille. Again, get into the spinning and the vibrato immediately. Mm. You have an idea of how you're wanting to do it, and I that's musical and it's beautiful. It's just not quite working for you today. Mm-hmm. Maybe tomorrow, maybe next month. But at the moment, you need to not hold it back. Mm-hmm. So, pa, can we start straight on passé? Even quicker. Passe.
Yeah.
Hit the note and immediately add a little bit of air on it. Hmm?
Passe.
Ba. A little bit more sound. Tu. Laissant toujours.
Yeah,
without the vibrato, because then it just sounds like a trill. Laissons toujours. Very clear notes.
Laissons toujours de si mal faire.
Yeah, okay. We're getting into the run-up to the end, and the piano is getting some really interesting things to do. Chum chum, chum. So that's beautiful how you're doing that. But and be very sort of crystallic, so it sounds super glossy. And you just need to do the Zen thing you did at the beginning. Go from Neji. Keep it going. Great. Can you a little bit more time. One, two. because this is so beautiful and we want to hear it. So a little bit more time before you come down and then also before you go to the B flat. Neige, one more time. Totally into my idea, except you need the courage to let sit on it a little bit longer. And again, you're taking a breath. Étoile. I don't think you need that.
Okay.
I think you have good breath control and you think it's going to be easier, but I think it maybe will be easy if you don't take a breath.
Okay.
But you have to fiddle around with that. D'étoile and place the parfum. The first phrase needs to Neige de blanc bouquet. Don't get behind because he's doing all kinds of things that are quite sort of rhythmical. De blanc bouquet, d'étoile parfum, winking me. And say me, d'étoile. So work out with your pianist that you're going to take a little, make time for the breath before this phrase and see how it feels. One more time from Neige. This is such a beautiful song and you're doing it beautifully.
Neige de blanc bouquet, d'étoile parfumée.
Get it spinning and sing it for a while and then stop and we can still hear it. Very good. Thank you so much.
Wie ich glühe, Galatea.
This is one of the Brettel songs, right? So sort of going towards or are sort of cabaret-ish.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So yeah, it's a funny song. And again, I haven't sung it myself, so I listened to some different versions of it. He's written sehr rasch. So I think if you can start faster, and then once the 16th notes begin, then maybe take it the tempo, but to have the tirom, 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 it sounds so slow at the beginning, not just you, everyone. So if you can speed that up, and then if you need to take the tempo down, you do. So, and every now and again, or very, very often actually, there are tenutos and there are ritardandos, and then another ritardando. It's a bit strange. Mm-hmm. And so you have to do your sort of own version of it. And I would be careful of getting too slow and too langsam. Do it more like a big rubato from beginning to end. Mm-hmm. Sometimes really fast, sometimes slow, sometimes really slow. But then once you've been slow, get going again. Otherwise it kills the song for me. Okay. Mm-hmm. So he's saying he wants to kiss her hands and her feet and everything. And then when he gets to the lips, he says he can't do it.
Yes, and because they're full charms, they're only meant to be kissed in a fantasy.
Yeah. Mm. So when he's saying, ach, wie brenn ich vor Verlangen, Galatea, schönes Kind, dir zu küssen deine Wangen, weil sie so entzückend sind, it's sort of like a nursery rhyme, the text. It's sort of childish, it's not big poetry. So I think sing it like that too. Okay. Ach, wie brenn ich vor Verlangen, Galatea, schönes Kind, dir zu küssen deine Wangen, weil sie so entzückend sind. It's a bit of a cabaret, the musical, willkommen, bienvenue. So do go a little bit more in that direction.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay, one more time. I like the sort of the energy, but it says to start in forte, so start even louder, bang away a little bit, but then just before the vocal line comes in, then you have to do a big diminuendo, obviously, and a little bit of a holding of the reins in, but before that, just go crazy a little bit. Okay. Ach, wie brenn ich mal lang. Ach, wie brenn ich vor Verlangen. Dido, dido, do, do, do. Yeah, don't get stuck. Classical singers always get stuck because we're trying to vocalize the whole time. Ach, wie brenn ich vor Verlangen, Galatea, schönes Kind. Breathe where you have to, but don't sing, sort of sing.
I see.
Beauty, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Just go crazy a little bit, you too. The beginning was good, except... So all this was good, and then when you this here from here it has to be more we have to be able to follow you. At the moment, it was a little, couldn't hear you. Again. Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
Entzücken. Yeah. Wangen, 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 get into the Wangen, otherwise perfect. Yeah, do it like that.
Okay.
Directly where you start.
Ach, wie brenn ich vor Verlangen, Galatia, schönes Kind.
Yeah, can you slow down the sextual? Digatatakata. Tidom, wapapapapapapa. It's a bit slower. Yeah, one more time, directly.
Ach, wie brenn ich vor Verlangen, Galatia, schönes Kind, dir zu küssen deine Wangen, weil sie so entzückend sind. Wange, die mir widerfahren.
Yeah. It does not say, do it half the tempo. That's the tempo you had. So remember, what was my tempo again? It was this fast. Wonne die mir wieder fahre. And then we have one ritardando followed by another one, followed by langsam, which means slowly. Come on, Schoenberg, what are you thinking about? But you know, get it up again, the speed. You, of course, you can linger a bit on the Wonne, but then Wonne die mir wieder fahre, Galatia, schönes Kind. And then that you've done your ritardando, and then we just can't get too slow. So langsam is not the dida dida. Okay, what's langsam in comparison? This dir zu küssen. So somewhere in between, but always get back to what was the original tempo and where am I in comparison to that? Where's the slowest point? The double ritardando must be the slowest point. Dir zu küssen deine Haare. So more look at what's the text saying and don't look too much. Slowly, not important.
Okay.
Wonne. Remember, but again, it's the case of being in German. Get deine, deine Haare,
deine.
No, don't do too much. Just
okay,
neutral. Deine Haare,
deine Haare,
deine. Let it hang out, hang down a little bit. Deine.
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 Yeah, you're trying to shape it. Mm-hmm. That's the thing that happens all the time. Deine Haare, deine. It's completely sort of open and nothing much going on.
Deine.
Yeah, deine Haare. So something to think about. Okay, good. Dir zu küssen deine Haare, weil sie so fell. And when I see 16th notes, then I do 16th notes. They can be quite slow, but not sort of that slow. Dir zu küssen.
Dir zu küssen deine Haare, weil sie so verlockend sind.
This is sort of like, what's the composer? In dem Schatten einer Locken, what's the composer? Well, thank you, Rolf. So do a Rolf thing. Dies ist auf ein Lockensind. He's wanting to go to Lockensind. Weil sie so verlocken sind, weil sie, if you're going to do it slowly, then you have to do it very, weil sie so, no, I would not. Weil sie so verlocken sind, very speech talky. Dir zu küssen deine Haare, do a bit of, add some sex on the Haare.
Dir zu küssen deine
Haare, not too soft. Dir zu küssen, understated volume. Dir zu küssen deine Haare.
Dir zu küssen deine Haare.
Yes.
Weil sie so verlockend sind.
Weil sie so verlock, weil sie so verlock. A little rocket at the back of that to get it going. Weil sie so verlock.
Weil sie so verlockend sind.
Yeah. Weil sie so verlockend. So luring, so appealing, so charming, so sexy. Weil sie so verlockend sind.
Weil sie so verlockend sind.
Yeah. So what I'm after is to act, sort of hover in time. Pa 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 pa. Weil sie so verlockend sind. In that silence, there's a lot of. Je ne sais pas quoi. Weil sie so verlockend sind.
Weil sie so verlockend sind.
Yes, I like that. Just hold your face. Okay, keep going. Weil sie so verlockend sind. One more, last time.
Weil sie so verlockend sind.
Chom, ching, chom, chom. Yeah, not too lit, not too, you know, feed it a little bit. Because nothing's going on, so it's you, and a little bit more. I would juice it up with some pedal. One more last time.
Weil sie so verlockend sind.
Chum, chum, chum. Yes, absolutely.
Nimmer wär mir, bis ich ende, Galatea schönes Kind.
Exaggerated. Weil sie so verlockend sind. Verlockend sind. You know, be a little bit exaggerated. Okay. In the audience's face. you've done it once already, and I think that's what this song is about. You know, it's getting very close to this person. One more time. From Nimmer wir mir bis ich ende.
Nimmer wär mir, bis ich ende, Galatea schönes Kind, dir zu küssen deine Hände,
weil sie so verlockend sind. Use the L.
Weil sie so verlockend sind.
Ja? Tiddly t.
Ach du ahnst nicht,
two in a
bar.
Ach du ahnst nicht, wie ich glühe. Your original tempo was pi ba ba ba, one, two, one, two. Now it's langsam so. Ach du ahnst nicht, wie ich glühe. Take it down, but don't think slow. Eighth notes, think slow. Quavers, whatever, it's quavers, right? Yeah. And do rubato on it. Ach, du ahnst nicht, wie ich glühe. It can be, the tempo can be very sort of rocky. It suits this style. Mm-hmm. Ach, or do your little Zwischenspiel.
Ach, du ahnst nicht, wie ich glühe, Galatea schönes.
Yes, and do what the Germans do. Schönes Kind. They almost, instead of singing a nice, pure, classical, Schönes Kind, they'll go, Schönes Kind. They'll do a little naughty diphthong on it. Schönes Kind. Sort of with a smile. ahnst nicht, wie ich glühe, Galatea, schönes Kind.
Okay.
Ach, du ahnst nicht, wie ich glühe, Galatea, schönes. It's almost sort of like Yiddish. Shay, add a Y.
Okay.
Shayness skin. I'm exaggerating wildly, but just so you get the idea. Shayness skin.
Shayness skin.
Shayness skin. So something to play with. Mm. Not too much, but you know, you should have it at the back of your mind.
Yeah,
that's
yeah,
that's sure. Something to think about. Last time, ach, du ahnst nicht.
Ach, du ahnst nicht, wie ich glühe, Galatea, schönes Kind. Dir zu küssen deine Knie.
Yeah, you're adding a T. Schönes, there's no T in that word.
Yeah,
schönes Kind. So again, from ach, du, and don't get too slow. Do your rubato, but pick it up afterwards. Ach.
Ach, du ahnst nicht, wie ich glühe, Galatea, schönes Kind, dir zu küssen deine Knie.
I want to kiss your knee. Yeah, do something with the knee. Ach, du ahnst nicht, wie ich glühe, I'm so on fire, Galatea, schönes Kind, dir zu küssen deine Knie. Yeah, use the back and forth of the tempo.
Mm.
Go from dir zu küssen deine Knie and really mean it.
Dir zu küssen deine Knie.
Yeah. At the moment you're singing a very fairly loud deine, but then you go back here. Deine Knie. If you want to do it like a subito piano on Knie, then it has to be more carried through that idea. Deine Knie, you know, with a different color, but not just getting softer.
Dir zu küssen, dir zu küssen deine Knie.
I would sing that short. Knie, a chord. Sing. There's no ritardando on, so shorten them a bit.
Okay.
Weil sie, he can't talk anymore. He's very, you know, excited. Küssen deine Knie.
Dir zu küssen deine Knie. Weil sie so.
I would sing those all those eighth notes very wah 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 wah. It's the first time he has that.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, it's been just one note.
Weil sie so verlockend sind.
Weil sie
so verlockend sind.
Lockend.
Lockend
sind. Again, the little split second of silence, like you did before so well. That's, again, the idea that
yeah.
I like.
Okay.
With you, but hold on to the E of the zint.
Zint,
zint. Yes, your zint. That word is part of the big flirting going on.
Zint.
Otherwise, it's a little bit too. It needs to be a little vulgar, if you understand.
Yes, I do. Yeah.
Do you want to do it again? And don't get loud too early. Weil sie so verlocken. So build it up a little bit more gradually.
Weil sie so
sorry to interrupt again. That should be, I think, a little louder, so we keep the tension. And you're imitate la wee wa wee. Yeah, wee wa 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 wee. Tom Pito. It needs to be pretty solo. You're playing the solo part. Which instrument shall we pick? Saxophone?
Ooh.
Yeah.
Baritone saxophone? Any other ideas?
No.
But you know, that's this song is asking for that. Could be cello too, but that's a bit too... Yeah, something a bit dirtier. So, just do lochen sie, lochen sie. I don't mean very long, but the feeling is long. Mm-hmm. Lockend.
Lockend sind.
Yes, nice.
Und was tät ich nicht, du süßer Galatea, schönes Kind, dir zu küssen deine Füße, weil sie so verlockend.
Yeah, I think he's tickling her. It's in his mind, he's tickling. Wah, 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 yeah. Or she's going in his dreams, but it's definitely part of the action. Good. When you're in the very low bits, just bring it out a little bit more, like you did at the beginning. Und was tät ich nicht?
Und was tät ich nicht, du süßer Galatea, schönes Kind, dir zu küssen deine Füße, weil sie so verlockend sind.
Song, so we need to think very hard about how we're going to sort of top it up. We're doing some big things already. Aber deinen Mund enthülle, Mädchen, meinen küssen nie. You're breathing, I think I would not breathe there. I would, aber deinen, where are you breathing? After enthülle, right?
Yes.
I would breathe after Mädchen because it makes more sense. Aber deinen Mund enthülle, Mädchen. Meinen küssen nie.
Mm-hmm.
If you didn't breathe, aber deinen Mund enthülle, Mädchen, meinen küssen nie. If you can do it without taking a breath and put the Mädchen, which is in the middle of this text thing, mm-hmm. within brackets, very audibly, and just get to the küssen, because it shouldn't be very slow anyway. Aber deinen Mund enthülle, Mädchen, meinen küssen nie. I'm sure you can do that. And then in seine Reize, do something with Reize fülle, and then you need to take more time. Denn in seine Reize fülle, küsst ihn nur die Fantasie. Wow, 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 wow. Because what we like to hear is küsst ihn nur die, and then the fantasie doesn't need to be super slow.
Mm-hmm.
So actually you're doing the ritardando on that bar, and then you're going up in a little bit of tempo. Aber deinen, okay, remember not to take a breath.
Yep.
And don't forget your, it's a long. Aber deinen munten Tülle Mädchen meinen küssen nie. You're going towards meinen küssen nie. That's the important thing. Everything before is just a road up to that point. Mm. So at the moment you're going, aber. Yeah, I mean, it makes sense to underline that because he's been talking about all the things he's going to do and then he's saying, but. So I get your point, but anyway, just try it for now. Mm-hmm. Can you do the two or three bars before? Is kissing you. Kiss, küsst ihn nur. You can take a breath there if you like. Kiss ihn nur die Fantasie. Küsst ihn nur die Fantasie. And hold on to your vowels. Don't stop. Fantasie. Long vowels. Okay. Denn in seine Reize fülle.
Denn
in seine Reize fülle.
Denn in seine Reize fülle.
No, it's good, but just küsst ihn nur, küsst ihn park on the word nur, küsst ihn nur die Fantasie, just so your brain remembers, you have to reset your program, your computer in there. Küsst ihn nur die Fantasie, I'm exaggerating as always, just to so you get the point. Denn in seine Reize.
Reize.
Yeah, and again, the second syllable of these words. Reize. Reize. It's a little bit more and not It's not open. Reize. It's neutral and nothing. It's sort of, but it has to have the right color. Reize fülle.
Reize fülle.
Yeah, that's better. Fülle. So actually, the fülle is darker than the Reize. Reize fülle. Denn in seine Reize fülle küsst ihn nur die Fantasie. Okay? Mm-hmm. One last time. Really, I want to hear the N without just sitting on it, but
Denn. Denn in seine Reize fülle, küss ihn nur die Fantasie.
Again, you want to say the Fantasie. Fantasie. Yeah, but when you sing it, don't worry so much about the N. Yes, can you do more crescendo here? Denn in seine Reize fülle, crescendo, and slow down. So one more time, denn in seine.
Denn in seine Reize fülle, küss ihn nur.
so the second syllable is not so important, but the third one is fantasie. Again, you're surfing, you're back on the wave on the last syllable. Fantasie, and the piano starts over. Shall we look at the Saint-Saëns?
Yeah.
Good work on this. Thank you.
Thank you.
And just enjoy it. We've
yes,
been
it's so much
fiddling
fun.
A lot with it, but sorry.
I'll take okay, that. Sorry.
In this song, very good. We need it to be. Can you just exaggerate the rubato, both of you? Si vous n'avez rien, si vous n'avez rien à me, si vous n'avez rien à me dire, pourquoi venir auprès de moi? Pourquoi me faire ce sourire? Qui tournerait la tête au roi? So there's a lot of whooshing this way and then whooshing back again. Tido di do di do pompo ting con con. It says also lento. And lento e capriccio. So he wants it slow. And what exactly he means by capriccio, I'm not sure, but he really doesn't want it. He doesn't say it's slow and smooth or slow and steady. He says capriccio. Mm. So a little bit, I think that can encourage our rubatoing. And rubato today is an unknown kunst. Rubato is not in fashion today. So music students, whether they're instrumentalists or singers, usually sing 1, 2, 3, 4. But it's sort of, you add so much life and colour just by pushing the tempo around, following the text. So can we do that again? Tom, a little slow. Tom, 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 ping. Yes. Written in a long crescendo. He has not said, he's not done a hairpin, which is the normal way. And so that your body and your mind doesn't want to do what he, I mean, I'm the same, I've sung this song. So you really need to, oh yes, 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 crescendo. So right to the end. It has that feeling. Si vous n'avez rien à me dire, si vous n'avez rien à me dire, pourquoi venir auprès de moi? 1, 2, 3.
Si vous n'avez rien à me dire, pourquoi venir auprès de moi?
So he's saying over and over again, pourquoi, why? So can you just linger a little bit on the word pourquoi? Pourquoi me faire ce sourire? Why are you smiling at me? Pourquoi me faire ce sourire? Madame,
pourquoi me faire ce sourire? Qui tournera la tête? Qui tourne de la tête, qui tourne de la tête.
And a nice crescendo coming up. Pourquoi me faire ce sourire? sing the second syllable a little bit more.
Pourquoi me faire ce sourire?
We have the French horn or the oboe going. Beep. Really sing it. I know it says dolcissimo. Yeah. Beautiful, not too fast. Yes, good. I think don't. It's more sad than that. It's not angry. It's really, really sad and lost. Sort of. Si vous n'avez rien à m'apprendre, pourquoi me pressez-vous la main? Yeah, you know, why do you keep coming to me and talking to me and smiling at me if you don't want me? So should have that. Si vous n'avez rien à m'apprendre, make yourself hold back, and so it needs to not get too loud on the piano. But that was beautiful how you played that. So just a few bars before. Portamento. Si vous n'avez rien à me prendre, pourquoi me pressez-vous la main? Vous la main. Just keep, sort of bind them together so they're not too separated. Yeah. Immediately, si vous n'avez rien.
Si vous n'avez rien à me prendre, pourquoi me pressez-vous la main sur les rêves géniques et tendres auxquels vous songez en chemin? Si
again, one of these stop on the bar line. Pourquoi me pressez-vous la main, la main? A little bit more time.
Okay.
I'm really sorry, the time is run out. It's 40 minutes. Let's just go to the end of the song so we hear that in all its glory. Pourquoi me pressez-vous from that bar?
Pourquoi me pressez-vous la main?
Nice.
Si vous voulez que je m'en aille, pourquoi passez-vous par ici?
Piano too. Wait, so not over yet. Now we learn. Pam, pam, jo, jo, jo.
Passez-vous par ici.
Passez-vous par ici. Pam, pam, da, du, du, du. The notes are so beautiful. Yeah, so don't get too soft too quickly. And save it. Keep it low. And then you explode. and then you keep it, and then you come down. So all this needs to be thought through. When is it important to be loud and when it's not? Mm-hmm. You understand. You get my gist. Thank you very much. Beautiful. Thank you.